Let's now move on to computation of expected NPV when you have multiple period project. Let's get started. Here you have the probabilities for net cash flows for 3 years project are as follows. So year 1, year 2, year 3, the cash flows and the respective probabilities are available, right? Then you are expected to calculate the expected net cash flows, also calculate the present value of expected cash flow using 10% discount rate, and you are given initial investment as ₹10,000. So here, if you want to find out the present value, that is basically net present value, you should know what is the present value of cash flows of each and every year, that is year 1, 2, 3, and within every year you have different events. Look at here, in year 1 itself you have 4 events, year 2 also 4, year 3 is also 4 events. So first you have to find out what is the expected cash flow for each and every year. And how do you find out the expected cash flow? It's simple. Take the cash flow, multiply by the probability, derive each and for each and every event, find out what is the expected value, sum them, that will give you expected cash flow for each and every year. So we'll do that now. Yeah, here you have, look at here, for year 1 the cash flows and the probabilities. Now multiply the cash flow with the probability so that you get the expected value. 2000 into 0.1 200, 4000 into 0.2 800, 6000 into 0.3 1800, 8000 into 0.4 3200. Now you have to total all the 4. When you total all the 4, you land on 6000. This is the expected cash flow for year 1. Similarly, year 2 you have the cash flows, probability, multiply each and every item, you get the expected cash flow. Total them, you get 4800, and year 3, 2000 into 0.3 600, 4000 into 0.4 1600, 6000 into 0.2 1200, 8000 into 0.1 800. Total all this you get 4200. So in this way you have the expected cash flows of year 1, year 2, year 3. Now multiply these expected cash flows with the discount rate and discount factor, and you know the discount rate is 10%, right? So let's have that. So we'll have this table where we'll compute the NPV. Columns are year expected net cash flows, discount factor at 10% and PV. In year 0, that is at the starting of the project, there is an initial investment of 10,000. So that is indicated with a minus sign, indicating it is an outflow. And the discount factor, obviously at the year 0, discount factor will be 1 only. So the present value is 10,000 into 1. It is minus 10,000, indicating it is an outflow. Whereas in year 1, 2, 3, we have calculated the expected net cash flows as 6,000, 4,800 and 4,200. That got to be multiplied with the discount factor at 10% for the year 1, 2, 3. For year 1, discount factor at 10% is 0.909, year 2 is 0.826, year 3 is 0.751. And we know how to compute this discount factor using your present value formula, or you can go for present value interest factor table also. At 10% across year 1, 2, 3, you will get all these values, okay? Then you have to find the PV, which is nothing but the expected net cash flow into discount factor. So 6,000 into 0.909, you get 5454. 4,800 into 0.826, you get 3965. 4,200 into 0.751, you get 3154. If you total all this, that is these three items, it will give you PV of inflows. Compare that with this 10,000, which is the PV of outflow, because your NPV formula is basically PV of inflow minus PV of outflows. So sum of these three minus 10,000 is giving a positive figure. So there is a positive NPV of 2,573.